And I will set certain parameters on the VSS software. So I will go to setup and then preset the setup so that I get to the factory default condition fast. Then I will first configure the sender frequency of this. Set my dilution so that I am able to achieve the dynamic range of the ADC inside the receiver. Okay. We have it here. Right, so this is a Wi-Fi signal which I have generated, and I will try to analyze this particular signal. So in the analyzer, we have various kind of modulation schemes, be it analog modulation like ENF-FM, be it the various digital modulations, various cellular comms modulations, RFID, wireless access, broadband wireless access, wireless networking, or ultra wideband. So we support various kind of modulation schemes. Then wireless networking, I'll choose the type of modulation that I've created. Have it here. So you have the constellation diagram of this modulated signal. I can further go into depth of the analysis and then keep on introducing various parameters. So I have multi-domain analysis available. So this is like oscilloscope-like time domain display, wherein I am seeing the burst of these signals in time domain. This is the constellation diagram wherein I have a pilot carrier. This is the BPSK pilot carrier and a 16 QAM payload, okay, which is actually carrying my data. See, this is the spectrum, which is the frequency domain analysis, and this is the error history that it is showing me the EVM values and the various other frequency error IQ modulation errors in this particular history. These are the measurements with respect to specific symbols. So for each symbol, I'm able to see how much is the error that is carried by that particular symbol. Okay. Likewise, you can add on various other parameters of the measurements in this particular instrument. Not only that, you can keep a record of that signal. So there is a record button, you can record that signal and then replay that signal. So let us say that the DUT is available for a very short time, record the signal, analyze post. So you can do post analysis of this particular signal offline. Not only that, from here, once you have captured that, recorded that signal, you can analyze, you can port that signal into the signal generator and then generate that particular signal from the signal generator. So we provide connectivity of VSA with the source also, so that whatever you are capturing, you can regenerate later. So let us say I have a device, output of the device I capture, port it into the signal generator, and I will generate the signal as if it is coming out from that DUT, and then test the next stage of my DUT from there. Okay, so these kind of modern features are available with these equipments, wherein you can maximize the usage of these equipments. So we have these education kits. So this is the transmitter kit, where we have various modules of the transmitter, RF transmitter, being integrated into one kit, and then we have test points at each of the stages, and then you can keep on adding jumpers to it to integrate a complete transmitter and characterize the complete transmitter here. Similarly, we have a receiver kit, where you can have various stages of a receiver like LNA at the front end, etc., and then you can analyze each of the component in isolation and combine them together to make a complete receiver. So this is what I have to share with you today. I will hand it over to Prateek to give you an overview of ADS. Before that, we are going to have a tea break, and then we are going to assemble back for a small session on ADS overview. Thank you.